Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Exotic Astrology again. And the other day I had made a video how Rahu cheats you, and many people said that Rahu cheats, but does Rahu help also sometimes? Well, yes, Rahu definitely helps us, and he also helps us by cheating. Okay, he helps us by cheating, by not cheating. By either ways, he is one of the planets, and as we know that the planets are tangible manifestations, or the ways by which Lord Vishnu manifests in this world, by which he acts, by which his supreme authority is felt in this world. So no planet is bad, all right? So anytime you see any video where any astrologer is speaking badly about any planet, you have to understand that he is not speaking badly about that planet personally. He is just highlighting the traits which that planet represents, all right? How they cause destruction in our life, like in the case of Rahu. But today's video is on how Rahu helps us, all right? So today we will see that ultimately, how at the end, by doing something, Rahu can still help us, all right? So if you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, then please subscribe to it. And if you want a consultation from me regarding your Rahu, Ketu, Saturn or any other planet, then you can go to my website to book a reading. You will find the link to my website in the description section of this video below, okay? And before I begin, as I always say, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will... I will not say the rest. All right. And yes, so I started lighting this, which Krishna Guruji had given me when I had gone to Indore, Ujjain. So I'm just putting this. It's so fragrant. This is so amazing, you know. This is every morning I'm putting this. And do you know which planet represents this? Dhoop. This is Saturn, actually. Saturn represents. So anytime you face any problem related to Saturn, anytime, then you can always light some dhoop. Dhoop jalao! Dhua aane do dhua. This is dhua. Dhua is coming and dhua is also Rahu. Yes, so before we discuss about Rahu, one small announcement I have to make is that as I announced earlier, that we'll be doing a webinar on the 12 houses in astrology, and one of the participants who registered, she suggested to me that, am I giving any kind of certificate there? So I said, no, I'm not giving. But then later on today, I was thinking that why not give a certificate also? So here is the announcement now that whoever is registering and whoever attends it, they have to attend that time personally, okay, for all the 4 hours. So that then when you attend it, then I will be handling you the certificates also after completion of that. All right. I don't know. First time I'll be giving certificates. But anyways, if that's what is requested, then I will fulfill it. All right. So in the video of how Rahu cheats you, I said that Rahu, he magnifies things, especially pertaining to the houses which have the Karakas, like Sun, Moon and Jupiter, which is the second house, the fourth house, the first house, the Lagna, of course, the Lagna, the second house, the fourth house, the fifth house, the seventh house, the ninth house and the 11th house, these 7 houses, all right? So if you have not watched that video, then please go and watch it first. But here, sometimes people ask that, how do we know Rahu will help us or he will cheat us? Well, the question is, Rahu always helps you. Sometimes he helps you by making somebody cheat you. By that, what he is doing is, he is cleaning away the karma which you had. Only Rahu does that, no other planet. So if you have cheated somebody, then that person will come back in this life and then that person will cheat you. So that is why it is said that we should not cheat. That's the reason, because then that karma will backfire to us. But sometimes people say, and in that video also you would have seen in the comments, that people said that, oh, this person became the biggest film star, this person became the prime minister, the president or the chancellor or a very big person during Rahu Dasha. And that happens. Rahu Mahadasha is of 18 years. And Antardashas also keep coming. But the question is, how Rahu actually helps you? See, what Rahu does is basically, Rahu can either give you or take from you, but at the end, he will make you frustrated. Now, you may be thinking, oh, he will link it to spirituality now, anyways. That's what you are thinking, right? No, I will tell you. It's scientific, actually. If you see the Vimshottari Dasha system, of course, I have not talked about Dashas now. I will talk about it very soon. It's on the list. So, if you see the Vimshottari Dasha system, then you will see that after 18 years of Rahu Mahadasha, we have Jupiter Mahadasha, which is for 15, 16, 17, 16 years. And then we have Saturn's Mahadasha for 19 years. So, the thing is, why in the universe does Jupiter Mahadasha come after Rahu Mahadasha? Have you ever heard? Have you ever thought? You are just like, oh, my Rahu has ended, Jupiter has started. That's all. Have you ever thought? Why has Parashara assigned Jupiter Mahadasha after Rahu? Why not before Rahu? If you know, then write it in the comments. Pause this. If you don't know, then the answer is because at the end of Rahu, when Rahu Mahadasha ends, you will feel deeply empty. You may be thinking, why? Because Rahu only eats. He has no place to store because his head is cut. Alright? So, when Rahu eats everything, either Rahu will either eat you and give something from you to somebody, or Rahu will eat somebody else and give it to you. Either of the two things Rahu will do. So, either ways, Rahu gives or takes from you. At the end, you will end up feeling that this is not what I wanted. Or rather, I would say, you may feel this is not what I needed. But that's exactly what you needed. Oh my God, it's so confusing. That feeling of emptiness is exactly what you need. You may feel, oh, I didn't need this, I didn't want this. But no, you may not want the emptiness, but that is what you need. Because Rahu is the only planet which has the power to make you a pauper, a beggar, or somebody who can put you in the throne. Because Rahu, remember, he has the power to eclipse the sun and moon. Always remember this. Rahu has the power. He can eclipse the sun and moon, which means he can throw the sun and moon. Throw means not only literal sense, but he can take their place. So, suppose somebody is there who is like a very popular or very renowned personality. They are like sun and moon. So, now Rahu can come and say, hey, get down. So, he can put you in the throne. You understand what I say? That is what Rahu can do sometimes. Or Rahu can do the opposite. Oh, you are sitting in the throne. It's your time. Come down. Now, he will sit. That's what Rahu can end up doing sometimes. Now, what Rahu does, how he will do, that will depend on your horoscope. That will depend on which sign Rahu is placed, which planets Rahu is aspecting, and which planets are aspecting Rahu. Should I repeat? Which planets are aspecting Rahu? Because Rahu Ketu gives also the results of the planets who are aspecting Rahu Ketu. And it also gives the result of the dispositors. Alright. So, let's take a simple case for Aries ascendant. Suppose Rahu is placed in the 6th house. Alright. Just an example. Rahu for Aries Lagna is placed in the 6th house in the sign of Virgo. Alright. And Saturn is placed in Pisces in the 12th house. Just an example. Then what is happening is, now Rahu will give results of the, and now suppose Mercury is placed in the 2nd house. Alright. Mercury in 2nd, Rahu in 6th, Ketu Saturn in the 12th house. Alright. Because wherever Rahu is, Ketu will be 7 houses apart. And suppose Ketu and Saturn are conjunct in Pisces. So now what's happening is Rahu will give the result of the dispositor. That means the dispositor is Mercury. So Mercury is ruling which houses? 3 and 6, because Gemini and Virgo falls in the 3rd and 6th house for Aries Lagna. And Mercury is sitting in the 2nd house. Alright, take care of this. Then 2, 3, 6. Now Saturn is aspecting Rahu from the 12th house, because Saturn aspects the 7th house. So Saturn is sitting where? It is sitting in the 12th house, and it is owning which houses? For Aries Lagna, it is ruling the 10th house and the 11th house. So now for this case, Rahu will give results of the 2nd house, the 3rd house, the 6th house, the 10th house, the 11th house and the 12th house. Now you understand why Rahu dashas are so much unpredictable. Because here the prime houses of the horoscope which make you wealthy, 2nd house, 10th house, 11th house are also linked, and the houses which can make you a pauper, the 6th house and the 12th house, pauper in the sense physically, materially, alright. They are very good houses for spirituality, even the 8th house. But on a material gross sense, I am saying these houses have the power to make you fall from your position sometimes. Alright. So now Rahu is giving results of all these houses. And then suppose some other planet is aspecting Rahu, or Rahu is conjunct with another planet, it will also give the results of that planet. Suppose Venus is also in Virgo in the 6th, then it will also give the results of the 2nd house. Because Venus is also ruling the 2nd and 7th, but 2nd already it is giving results because Mercury is sitting there, and Mercury is the dispositor of Rahu. You understand what I say? Complex. Just write it down in a paper, you will understand. Okay. So that is why Rahu dashas are very, very, very unpredictable, because it can give you the extremes, like here 2, 10, 11, extreme good, 6, 12, extreme negative. Alright, on a gross sense, again I am saying, on a materialistic sense. But the thing is, either Rahu gives results of 2, 10, 11 or 3, 6, 12, either irrespective of that, the trait of Rahu is at the end of Rahu, it makes you very empty inside. It gives you a feeling that I need something else which is not at all related to all this. And that is why the Jupiter Mahadasha comes that time, because that is the time, because see, Rahu is the pinnacle of material civilization. It's the end. Anything new which comes is Rahu. So when you have experienced Rahu totally, it's like saying you have experienced the material world completely. Depending on other things in the horoscope, of course. Then you don't have anything else to experience. Now suppose somebody is born in Shatabhisha Nakshatra. So his Mahadasha will start from Rahu. Alright. Because wherever the Nakshatra of Moon is, from that planet's rulership, the Mahadasha starts. And there's another system called as Utpanna Vimshottari, which is sometimes applicable for some specific placements, like Moon in the 3rd house. That's calculated in a different way, but we will not go to that now. That's a topic of some other day. But the point is, when Rahu completes, or I would say when you have experienced Rahu, you have experienced this material world in totality. You have seen all the colors. You have seen all the, because see, material world means two things. Krishna says in the Gita, Bhoga Ishwarya Prasaktanam Taya Parita Chetasam. That sloka is there. Yes. So material world is like the two sides of the same coin. It's enjoyment and pleasure suffering. Enjoyment is this side, suffering is this side. But the thing about a coin is, if you like, this is the key. I am picking this key. So suppose this side is enjoyment, this side is suffering. So the moment I pick the key, I am picking both simultaneously, both the sides. I cannot pick one, because you will see, whenever you get happiness materially, you are doomed to cry later. Have you seen people crying after breakups or having a divorce? Why are they crying? Because they had the best times with that person, right? If some close person of ours, they leave us, we feel very much pained. Now, There are so many people dying every day. Why we don't start crying? Why we don't start feeling bad when we get the news that, oh my God, some unknown person has passed? Maybe we may feel bad, but we don't start sitting and crying, oh my God, that person has died. You know what will happen? But suppose somebody who is very near and dear, very close to us, they pass, then our situation becomes, then we feel as if we have also died with them. Why? Because we have sweet memories. So you see, this is the sweet and this is the kadwa. Okay, that's the bitter part. So in this material world, the moment you take material pleasure, always remember, the moment you take material pleasure, suffering is inbuilt in that. It is there on the other side. And that's what Krishna also says, that suffering is inbuilt, that dukkhalayam ashashvatam napnuvanti mahatmana samsiddhim palamam gata. Rahu mahadasha, or Rahu's dasha, or Rahu's placement is simply an indication of this shloka. Yehi samsparsha jabhogan dukkhayo naivate adyantavanta kaunteya nate shuramate buddhaha. Yehi samsparsha jabhogan dukkhayo naivate. Samsparsha means touch. Whenever you touch anything material, by touch they generally refer to as the touch between a man and a woman, the pleasure of sex which they get when they unite. Because that's the highest level of pleasure which is available in this material world. At least in Bhuloka, it's like that. So, yehi samsparsha ja bhogan. Bhoga is enjoyment. Dukkha yonayayavate. Dukkha, Krishna is telling this. I am not telling this. Krishna is telling, it will end in dukkha only. And then he says, adyanta vanta kaunteya. Adi anta. These kind of material pleasures have a beginning. Adi anta. Adyanta vanta kaunteya. O son of Kunti, these pleasures have a beginning and an end. Because when a man and a woman are uniting, it may seem in the pornographic movies, like people may write mails and inquire in Google that how long can a man and woman unite. Sometimes people send these mails to me also, that how to elongate the duration of sex, yes, because it gets over very fast. How to do that? Well, Krishna says, either you elongate or you don't. Adyanta vanta, adi and anta, they have a beginning and they have an end. Even if you drag it for 4 hours or for 8 hours, it will still end. And then he says, nate shuramate buddha, which means, he says that an intelligent person does not delight in such things. Alright. So now basically here Krishna is not telling that you should not unite with the opposite sex, because Krishna also says in the Gita, dharma viruddho bhuteshu kamosmi bharatarshabha. He says that I am that sex life which is not contrary to regulative principles, to the principles of religion, which means that sex after marriage for procreating children, that is the right attitude which one should have. But nowadays in society, what is happening is the opposite is happening. They have legalized premarital sex, or within marriage also nowadays there are so many affairs, all right and people think it's okay to do all this. So what happens is, when you are doing all this, your Rahu factor is getting more and more spoiled. So Rahu's ability to do good for you is getting diminished every moment when we are indulging in all this. And then Rahu represents all this: drinking, smoking, all these, watching pornography, watching adult material, entire mafia, all these things, gangsters, killings, rapes, all these things are under Rahu. Corruption, anything which is against the law, against Jupiter and Sun. Sun is the government, Jupiter is the law. Anything which is against the law is Rahu basically. And anything that you try to do by going against the law and you try to be successful, that itself is Rahu. So when you do all these things, then what happens is you force Rahu to teach you the lessons the hard way. Then you will see people typing in the comments, oh, my Rahu Dasha came and my girlfriend left me. Then these things happen. Then you will see people writing, oh, in my Rahu Dasha, my father left, my mother left, or anything of that sort. You will see YouTube is filled with all these comments. Hate comments about Rahu, Saturn and Ketu. It's full of hatred. But when we understand the lesson of Rahu, what is the lesson of Rahu? That materialistic pleasure will not satisfy you. Because Krishna says, in the Vedanta Sutras it is said that Anandamayo Bhyasat, the soul is looking for unlimited pleasure. Anandamayo Bhyasat. That cannot be found in such petty material things. Now, this does not mean that you renounce the world and go to forest. This does not mean that. It means that you maintain your material life, but at the same time, you maintain your spiritual commitments. You elevate your spiritual life, your spiritual consciousness which is inside you. Then automatically, at the end of Rahu, you will understand that, okay, I wanted all this and I got it, or I lost it, either of the two. But either ways, I am not happy. If at the end of Rahu's time, you can take Antar Dashas also, any Mahadasha you are undergoing, or you can take Pratyantar Dashas also, they are very short. If at the end of Rahu's period, now Pratyantars will depend on the Ayanamsha and the software which you are using, so they are a bit debatable, I would say, the time periods, but the Antar Dasha is to some extent, you can relate to it, okay, like, because Antar Dashas are quite long generally. So you can see that at the end of Rahu's time, if you get a feeling inside that I'm not satisfied, then you are very lucky, honestly. You are very, 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 very lucky, because that means you have got help from Rahu. Rahu has helped you to understand that you will never be happy in this material world. Because whatever you eat, you can't digest. Yes? So Jupiter says, stay married to one person, stay faithful, stay loyal. But Rahu says, hey, why? I can have affairs, right? It's okay, it's fine. Nowadays, there's this trend. Na? Anything you say that why you're doing this, people give a standard answer. Everybody does. That's the answer people give. Now, if you say that, why are you indulging in premarital sex, then they'll say, oh, everybody does. So, just because everybody is doing, it doesn't become good, or it doesn't become good for your soul. Alright? Just because, anyways, change the topic. So, the number does not decide the principle. That's how Rahu cheats you. And at the end, if you feel that, yes, I got it, but I was not satisfied, you know. Then you should say with your folded hands, thank you, Rahu. Because now you will be in a position to look for something higher in life. Because now the kind of frustration which you will have will be motivated from the fulfillment of desire. Yes, 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 yes. Frustration does not only come from unfulfilled desires, it also comes from fulfilled desires. Imagine the level of frustration which you get when your desire is fulfilled but still you are not happy. Write in the comments if you have had that experience. You wanted something so bad. It's like, I want it. Oh my God, I want it. I got it, but then it's gone. That's how materialistic pleasure is. It is like, have you seen that jugunu desa na? It's flying like that. So sometimes it lights, sometimes it dims. Materialistic pleasure is like that. The moment you touch something, it's gone. The moment you get something, you're like, okay, it's nice, not bad, but it's not definitely that what I expected. So if you get this feeling when Rahu ends, then you should be very thankful. You consider yourself very lucky, because you can have two things in this world. Either your desires are fulfilled or your desires are not fulfilled. Yes? Human population, 7 billion people. I don't know how much is the population now. All the animals, everybody, all the living beings, or maybe you can take non-living also, they fall in these two categories. Either their desires are getting fulfilled or in some area it's not getting fulfilled. But Rahu is that planet which tells you either your desires are fulfilled or you are not, or they are not fulfilled, you will still be miserable. That's the greatness, that's the beauty of Rahu. And only Rahu can do that. No other planet can do it. Jupiter can simply tell you this is there in Gita, this is there in Bhagavatam. But that experience only Rahu can give. But they say that experience is the best way to learn, and a fool learns by no other way. So ideally we should not wait till Rahu beats the hell out of us. Maar maar ke tumba bana diya tera. And then you are like, oh yeah, yeah, Rahu, I understood, you know. Don't beat me now. Now I have understood. Either I have enjoyed with 10 ladies or my girlfriend cheated on me. But I understood, you know, material world is a difficult place to live. We should focus on spirituality. Do not force Rahu to torment you. Should I repeat? Do not force Rahu to torment you. Do not force him. Learn the lesson. See, intelligent person is one who learns the lesson before only. If the police is coming, keep your passport ready. Or else he will come and say, show your passport. And you are searching. He's like, why do you need so much time? You are not a citizen of this country. I will reap your outcome. Don't wait for Rahu to torment you, to torture you. Rahu simply wants to tell you one thing, that you will not find happiness in this material world. Ultimate happiness, of course. Petty things, pleasure you will find. You indulge with somebody for some minutes. You go and get a Gucci bag, Louis Vuitton bag. Yes, so many ladies, they keep searching all these bags. So many men, they are searching cars. Rolls Royce Phantom, they are searching. Their fantasy is increasing every moment when they see the Rolls Royce Phantom. One of my friend is there here. He is too much obsessed with cars. The only thing he talks is car, 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 car. So that's how you see men and women behave at times. So Rahu wants to tell you that whatever you get in this world, either whatever it is you get or you don't get, at the end you will cry only. See, if you lose something, you will cry now. If you get something, you will cry when you lose it later. Either ways, you will cry in this world. Suppose you become a millionaire and you are like, you have the best husband or wife in this planet. And everything is fine. Suppose it's like an ideal world. Imagine no problems, never. Then what will happen to you at the time of your death? My God, how much will you cry? Suppose the doctor says one day, you have cancer, you are going to perish, my dear sir. Within 3 months, you will die. Then what will be your situation at the end? You will be miserable, right? You will be millions and billions and trillions of times more miserable than a person who lost something in some point of his life. Because you had all those happy memories, you know, you were always in the la-la land with all those $1 million. So at the end, you will anyways have to cry. Provided you do not cultivate spiritual knowledge. Provided. Now, if you are elevated spiritually, if you have that spiritual consciousness, then no problem. Rahu's lesson is learned. Then you don't have to worry. People fear Rahu, but they don't fear Rahu actually. They are fearing themselves because they know that there is poison inside them. Have you seen Rahu in 7th house people generally? Now again, I am not generalizing. Don't write in the comments, oh, what you are saying is wrong, you don't know anything. Generally, we will see if somebody has Venus and Rahu together, or Rahu associated with Venus, or Rahu associated with the 7th house, or moon generally. You will see these people, they'll flood the internet, YouTube and other places. Come on, oh my God, my Rahu is with Venus, you know, my relationships never work. Your relationships are not working because of Rahu. Because you are like that, that is why Rahu is associating with Venus. Stop blaming Rahu. Rahu doesn't do anything. Alright? Rahu will only sit there where you cheat. Rahu will only sit there where you have a feeling that I will try to enjoy so much here that I don't need God. Alright? So only there Rahu is going to sit. No other place Rahu will sit. Wherever Rahu is sitting, whichever sign of either ways you call it, you are trying to extract maximum out of there, from that house. All the pleasure of the universe, you are trying to suck from there. That is why they say that's the place where you find the highest level of frustration, because that's where you fail the most. So at the end, the conclusion is very simple, that either Rahu gives you or he takes from you. At the end, you will have to cry if you do not have spiritual consciousness which is elevated. Because at the end of your life, you will anyways be stripped of everything. Your mother, father, husband, wife, daughter, sister, nobody is going to stay with you. At the end, they will leave, or you leave them. And that is why Krishna says in the Gita that antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram. Antakale cha mameva smaran muktva kalevaram. Antakala, the desire that you have at the end of your life will decide your next birth. Now you understand why 7th house is the house of desire. Because that is where the sun is setting. The sun will again rise depending on which desires you are cultivating. So, if you are cultivating spiritual desires, meeting spiritual personalities, reading the scriptures, reciting the shlokas, then you will definitely be able to remember God at the end of life. As they say, Antakale Narayana Smriti. That is very, 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 very important. Or you are thinking, oh, my wife was so sweet. She used to say, Janu, tum kab aoge office se? Kab aoge batao na Janu? Yes. If you are thinking of your wife like this, then next life, stamp. Take the body of a woman, then there will be another man you will attract, or you get attracted to another man, then again the cycle keeps repeating, you know, it's like this cycle which keeps on going. To this life you become the husband, and then next life you become the wife, yes, and you are beating each other every day, either by loving or by hitting, because at the end anyways you will cry, right? But when we cultivate our spiritual consciousness by doing spiritual practices every day, doing mantras, reading scriptures, or you can recite the Brahma Samhita. Man, I have recited so many times. Do you want me to recite again? It's already 33 minutes. Now you will tell that I am making long videos. Okay, so I'll stop. So there you go. If you are new to the channel and if you have not yet subscribed, and you can subscribe below, and if you want a consultation from me, you can go to my website. That link also you'll find down. Alright. And if you want to register for the webinar, that link also I will put down. It's there on January 6th, and you will also be getting a certificate. I'm tired, man. Alright. God is there with you all the time. Look to Him and hope you find Him. Okay. You must find. Okay. Bye bye. See you.